Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN. And today we're talking about, can a man throw off a woman's pH? Let's dive into it. It's important to talk about this because these are common things that affects us all the time as females, and we're always asking these questions. So I am going to talk about the details and nip a few myths in the butt so that we can get down to the real truth behind a man throwing off a woman's pH. So in this video, you will learn about pH balance, vaginal pH levels that are most optimal. How does the vaginal pH level protect against infections of all types? What types of things may cause higher pH levels in the vagina? And exactly how a man may help to throw off your vaginal pH. Let's dive into it. Vaginas love to be acidic. This is where they're happiest. This is where they function the way they should. This is where they want to be. And so we want to keep everything acidic down there because we know that in general, a happier vagina leads to a vagina without problems, a vagina without infections. And so let's talk about pH and why this plays such an important part of balancing your pH and how things can be thrown off by our activities. So with that, I'm going to go ahead here and demonstrate to you a little bit about the pH scale. The pH scale is a scale that ranges from 0 to 14. So we'll make this 0, we'll make this 14, and dead center, we'll make this number 7. This is very important because in this pH scale, things will vary from being acidic on this side to being basic on this side. And this is really the key to everything that happens with pHs, levels of the vagina, and how a man can throw off your pH. So let's add a little bit of details here. We'll make everything that's acidic red, okay? So on the far left, the most acidic item that I'll list here is, let's start with batteries. Hopefully you can see this. And then next to batteries, we'll put on lemons. So lemons are probably somewhere around a pH of 2. Let's add on a few more items. Let's throw on tomatoes. Tomatoes are around the level of about a 4 pH. So that gives us a nice range on the acidic side. Now let's switch over to the basic side and we'll make this blue for you. In the center, we'll skip that a bit. Let's first put blood, okay? Blood is a pH somewhere around 8. Very close to that would be like baking soda. Let's make that a 9. So we'll put that pretty close. Let's add one more. Some of the soaps that we use, they're actually pretty basic and they're somewhere probably around 11 or so. So we'll just say soaps. And then all the way at the far end, let's add on like drain cleaners, you know, cleaning supplies. So I'll just say Drano,
basic. Vaginas like to be on this side of the pH scale. Okay, and in fact, they like to be right in this area here, which is about a 4 to a 4.5. So let's say vaginas are happiest right there. Right in the center of neutral, we can say here we have water. So on average, water would be about a pH of 7. And let's add one more important factor here. Let's add on sperm and semen. I'm just gonna bring it down here and we're gonna say this is sperm, semen. Now, all three of these green items affect our pH on a regular basis. We have vaginas, we wanna be over here, we love it. And I'm just gonna start because that's where we wanna be. Water, we shower with water. We sometimes try to put water inside the vagina. We have blood, which really, we should probably make that one green as well, because we have periods. If we're in our reproductive years, which is a pH somewhere around 7 to 8, but then semen falls in that range as well. Now, the concern here is that whenever we have something that's acidic and basic come together, they neutralize. So if we brought a vagina, which is somewhere around 4.5, together with semen around 8, they neutralize, and so the pH of the vagina will move, and instead of it being here, it will move into this direction and probably will move towards being neutralized. And you may think this is okay because it's neutralized, but guess what? Vaginas don't like to be neutralized. They like to be acidic. So if you have unprotected sexual intercourse, semen is released into the vagina. The vagina then becomes less acidic. And once it becomes less acidic, it is now prone to getting infections, bacterial vaginosis. You can even get STDs because the pH level has changed. And what happens is that once your pH level changes, you don't have the protection in the vaginal area anymore. You don't have the coverage that you need to allow the bacteria and the yeast and the fungus and everything that is in the area to continue to protect your environment. Everything shuts down, and now you're vulnerable to getting infections. And this is how males or men can throw off your pH. Now, does that mean get rid of your husband or your boyfriend because they happen to carry sperm and semen on the other side of the pH scale? No, it doesn't. But it does mean that we should identify what our risk factors are for infections as far as what triggers infections within our system. So it takes investigation. It takes sitting down, writing down your activities, knowing exactly when infections occur so you can try to fix them. But let's jump back to the scale just a bit here. Periods may do the same thing. Why? The pH of blood is somewhere around 7 to 8, which is greater than where vaginas want to be. So if you have long periods, heavy periods, you have problems with more bleeding in between your cycles after sex, and so many other reasons why you could, the more that you have blood in the vagina, the more neutralized your vagina becomes and throws off your pH. So blood can do that as well. The same thing with water. It's a part of the reason why we recommend not putting anything inside of your vagina. Because when you increase water or anything being placed inside of the vagina, you automatically are moving the vagina from where it likes to be and bringing it in the direction of where it doesn't want to be. Now, what items may play a part with this? Well, douching, probably something that back in the days were the process that people would use on a regular basis. People go to the store, get to the pharmacy, pick up a douching container, or they may even make it at home. And as soon as they would have sexual intercourse, they'll insert this douche into the vagina, wash it out, and feel as though they are a new person. But we have found that in douching, you're actually washing away all the bacteria and the things that protects your vagina, increasing the likelihood of you getting an infection and actually throwing off your pH. So no douching. Other factors may be the fragrances and the soaps and the chemicals that you put next to the vagina, the things that you wash your vagina with. They may also throw off your pH because of chemicals, and chemicals tend to be on this side. So we're looking at baking soda. I'm pretty sure if you actually took a lot of the products off the shelves in the store, you'll see that a lot of the chemicals that are being used in your vagina are made with some degree of baking soda within them. And so baking soda is on that other side. We want to leave these things alone. Soaps on this side, we don't want that. And so you want to get products and use products that are more neutralized and things that are very simple and as light as water to be able to wash and clean the vaginal area so that you're not increasing the likelihood of getting an infection. So how do you know if your pH is off? Well, your body will tell you.
Your vagina will tell you. You'll have symptoms. You will have discomforts down below. You will have irritation down below. You may have differences in your odor and just smells that are not something that you're typically used to. You will know because you'll have swelling in the area. You'll have testing done by your provider, which may recurrently come back as having an infection such as bacterial vaginosis or STDs or yeast infections because your vaginal pH is not where it likes to be. And so it doesn't necessarily mean that your partner's cheating on you. It doesn't mean that your partner is giving you an infection. It often just means that your partner's natural body, because we can't change your sperm, we can't change how semen, what the composition of it. We just know that this is the fact of life. And so they may influence your body just because of naturally how their bodies are. And so if you're dealing with your pH being off, this might be a time for you to sit down, have a conversation with your partner, how you'd like to proceed with sexual encounters. Would you like to pull out? Would you like to use condoms to decrease the likelihood of having that exposure? You may want to be sure that after sexual activity that you're going to the bathroom right away. And if there was semen released in the vagina, that this semen drains, okay, and leaves the vaginal space, decreasing the amount of time that semen will have to interact with your vaginal space so that your pH is not being thrown off. I hope this all makes sense today. Listen, I want to dive in a little bit deeper with you, talking about your hormones and your body, especially the vaginal space. And with that, I want to give you a free copy of my ebook, Hormones Don't Lie. With that, we talk so much more about the female hormones, the female body, and how we can best balance it. And so with that, click the link below so that you can get a copy of that sent right over to your inbox. In the meantime, I want you to know I'm so thankful that you're here on my channel, learning together. And so it's a pleasure for me to be here. And I'm Dr. Perkins, again, a board-certified OBGYN. This is what I love to do on a regular basis. So this is why I'm here, and I'm glad that you're here with me too. I can't wait to see you on the next video. Take care. See you next time.